Good morning, Corey.
Stevie.
Corey.
It's not morning.
What the fuck?
It's morning somewhere.
What the fuck?
It's morning somewhere.
I guess it... No. These podcasts come out in the morning. You're just... Oh, that's me being terrible already.
We lost our YouTube funding right there.
Oh.
I'm just kidding.
Wait, I said fuck?
Yeah. Oh, how you doing,
Corey? I can't
Corey?
Help it.
How you doing?
I can't help it. I'm good. It's been a crazy. I feel like I've lived three lifetimes since the last pod.
You've shed your skin and risen as the phoenix three times.
Really? Damn.
That's what you said.
I don't think all that. I'm just saying it's been forever.
Yeah.
A lot's changed. We're in a new fucking space. Look at this.
Oh my god. Oh my god, we are. When did we get here?
It'd be funny if we like recorded the first bit of this at the old spot, and then we're like, we're in a, you know, like snap, like new fucking place. Like,
oh, that would be great.
And then you did the scared bit.
Yeah, that'd been so funny.
That'd have been good. Speaking of bits, did you make a commercial?
No.
Neither did I. Okay, good.
Were we gonna make a commercial?
Remember?
Oh yeah!
All right, good. We both forgot.
But I forgot because there. So we weren't here last week, but we're here to this week. So it's been a week.
You're saying you would have been ready last week?
No, not at all.
Okay. How are you?
I'm doing good. Doing good. Big chilling.
You doing good?
Yeah.
Amazing.
Excited to be here on Movie Club episode 95.
96.
Episode 96.
Yep. Episode 96. I was testing the Movie Club podcast.
The Movie Club podcast. I was testing you.
You were testing me.
See if you knew which week it was.
You see any movies this week?
Yeah.
What'd you watch?
I watched Creed 2.
Watched Creed 2?
Yeah, it's been a while. I saw Creed 1, like, right, not in theaters, but right when it came out of theaters. And I just hadn't seen Creed 2. And I want to see Creed 3 in theaters, so I watched Creed 2, and it was incredible. It was awesome.
Yeah, I haven't seen any Creed movie, but I...
Or a Rocky movie?
Was damn near wanting to see...
What about Rocky movies?
No, I haven't seen any Rocky
really?
Movies either.
Dude, they're great. They're great. I mean, like, you know, like, they're pretty formulaic in some ways, but the fight scenes are just so good. I'm excited to see Jonathan Majors go against Michael B. Jordan.
Michael B. Jordan. Yeah, I'm excited. I heard the movie's really good. I heard the movie's really fucking good.
I gotta get your take on it. Michael B. Jordan, corny or not, for the interview.
For the interview?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, it's not that bad, but it's pretty. It's kind of bad, but.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, yeah, it's not that big of a deal, but.
I feel like he handled it well enough.
Yeah. I didn't see it, so I don't even fucking know.
That's fair. That's fair.
I can't even accurately. I can't even accurately judge it.
You watch any good
movies? Why are you looking at my screen?
What? It's just right there.
Why you? I hate this.
It's right there.
Why are you sitting next to me, bro? There's a whole other... No, I'm just kidding.
You sent me here. I could have sat over there.
No, I'm just kidding.
You teleported me in this room. We were in the other place, and I just opened my eyes, and I was here.
What movies you watch this week?
Besides Creed 2?
Yeah. Anything else?
I watched the movie that we watched for this week.
Oh, yeah, besides it.
Wait, do you know I watched a movie?
I'm wondering if you went and saw a movie, maybe.
I didn't go see the CB.
Why not?
I lived it. No, I'm just
you
kidding.
You lived it.
I'm just kidding. No, I just haven't seen it yet. Did you like it? I want to hear your thoughts on it.
You want to hear my thoughts on it?
Yeah, definitely.
It's
not like you're going to spoil the plot. I mean, I don't think it has a crazy plot.
Yeah. Yeah, but I mean, there's just things to it, you know. There's been one thing I have been spoiling for people. Just one little, like, beginning plot. And it's just that the kids are the first ones to find the cocaine, right? And it's so funny because they're, like, hiking on their own just trying to find, like, they, like, skipped school and, like, went to go hike the mountain.
That's
you know
wild.
What I mean? And then they, like, this little girl's like, I think this is cocaine. You know what I mean? And then the little boy's like, yeah, that's definitely cocaine. He's like, me and Edgar used to do that, you know, like. And she's like, here, do something. He's like, oh, no, you can't do cocaine and exercise at the same time. Like, we're exercising. Like, And she's like, I'm going to do something. She cuts it open with a knife. And then she, like, gets, like, a whole bunch. And she's like, how much do you do? And he's like a tablespoon full. And she's like, okay. Eats it.
Oh, my gosh.
All of it. So much. And the whole theater erupts.
Laughing?
Yeah. It's just like, whole, you know, like, everyone's, like, shocked, you know. Like,
dude, that's hilarious.
And then she's like, here, you got to do some. And then the little boy's like, I don't really want to. But then he takes a whole scoop full, too.
Damn.
So you're just like, fuck. It just starts off with two little kids eating cocaine.
The one thing that is kind of wild to me is how unfazed I am and, like, seemingly the majority of the population that there is a movie with cocaine in the title and, like, cocaine being a big part of the plot premise. It feels like when Superbad or Pineapple Express must have come out, you know what I'm saying, in a way, where, like, people were like, oh, pot, how edgy.
Yeah.
And, like, now they're cocaine, how edgy. And it's like, whoa, where have we gotten?
Yeah, so, like, what if that got legalized in, like, 20 years?
I could see it being decriminalized. Legalized would be wild.
Yeah, that'd be crazy.
It's decriminalized in parts of the country.
Really?
I mean, like, not, like, you can't get charged for it.
Where?
Like, possession.
Where?
Oregon.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Or Portland, maybe, specifically.
That's crazy.
Just possession. But, like, if you were, like, trying to sell it.
Yeah,
or distribute
of course.
It, yeah.
But that's still crazy that, like, it's not, like, an illegal drug, technically. You know what I mean? Like, you can just casually do it easily.
That's the war on drugs expiring.
Yeah, but I just don't like some drugs.
That's fair. I mean, that's fair.
I don't like cocaine.
That's fair.
Weed being legalized is cool, but, like, I don't know. It'd be weird.
Well, it wouldn't be legalized.
I know.
I mean, if, like, if someone wants to do it in the privacy of their own thing and it's not bringing me any harm, that's fine.
Yeah, of course.
But, I mean, it starts to be a thing if, like, I'm driving down the road and someone's like,
yeah,
I'm on cocaine, bitch.
Yeah. And I'm just worried because there was a dude kicking the door next door and I'm like wondering, they might be. Never mind.
Who knows?
Never mind. But welcome to Movie Club, man.
What did you rank?
Oh, yeah. What did you
rank Cocaine Bear?
Yeah, I'll talk about Cocaine Bear more. Cocaine Bear was really good.
Did it meet your expectations?
It exceeded them, you know, which is good. You know what I mean? But it also, like, you know, like, there are some complaints, obviously. Like, I think it, like, I don't know. I think a lot of movies have been doing it well, like, as far as, like, having, like, those, like, 90s vibes really well. You know what I mean? Like, just those old movie structures. You know what I mean? And this one does it well, I think. You know what I mean? Like, the ending is, like, a big set ending. You know what I mean? And it's, like, you remember how every movie used to end with that? Like, a big set?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? With, like, waterfall. And it was, like, a created set.
Like Avatar 2.
Kinda, yeah. You know what I mean? But Avatar 2 looks so fucking good. And this looks good, too. You know what I mean? But this just, like, this just felt like it could have came out in, like, 96, and it would have made sense. You know?
80s.
Like, yeah.
That's cool. That's what I was kind of hoping for.
Yeah.
It's, like, kind of a vintage-y feel.
Yeah, but it's a great story, like, about just so many different people. It's one of those, like, you know what I mean? It just kind of jumps around, and you never know who it's going to next. And
we're checking out in theaters?
Yeah, I'd say. You know what I mean? It's good for home, but it's a fun theater experience, and it's, like, kind of shocking. It's I mean, Stevie, it's also a little gory, bro. Like,
I'm cool with that.
They definitely push the boundaries with that. You know what I mean? As funny as it is, it's also like they nail all the tones as well as they could. You know.
You ever seen a bear in the wild?
No, fuck no. Have you?
Yeah.
Really?
Not like in any crazy wild, just in national parks.
Yeah, no, I haven't.
And just never a grizzly either.
I've never really been, like, out there hiking in, like, crazy parks.
I had a moment when I was, like, living in Colorado, and I was driving over the mountain to the other location, and I got out to take pictures, and it was, like, sunset, and I was the only one on the top of this mountain, and, like, it was pretty well deserted for, like, the last hour probably, and I just, like, heard something, and then I got this, like, eerie feeling of, like, I am alone with no service on the top of this mountain. Like, you know what I'm saying? Happens, I don't know. Yeah, it's like moving hour because it's golden hour. And like, yeah. People are trying, like, animals are trying to move to where they're going to sleep. I don't know. I was just like, I got to get out of here.
That's crazy. Moving hour.
Yeah.
I heard that term before.
I don't even know if it's a real term, but it's just in my brain.
Really?
Yeah.
You made that up?
Yeah, right.
That's
now.
That's good. Moving hour. But people talk about like golden or like golden hour or golden time. Like,
I feel like they're, well, especially because the park is a lot less active. It's like less cars, so things are moving around more. Mm. But I have heard stories of like gnarly bear fights, and bears are scary.
Yeah,
bears on cocaine—that sounds extra scary. Yeah, and entertaining.
The movie does this little like opening scene, and then it like you know like the next thing is just like a little like scenic like thing of like the forest, and then it says this little quote, and it talks about how something about how, like, oh, brown bears are, like,
Yeah, you make noise at brown bears, right?
Yeah, brown bears are, like, okay, you know, something about, like, brown bears, it's, like, okay to, like, or brown bears, like, you play dead, you know what I mean? But black bears, you have to fight back or something like that, like, and then it said, who made that quote? And it was, like, Wikipedia.
Nice. That is the if you ever see, like in the Smoky Mountains, they have a lot of black bears. Like the little, they're littler, and if you make noise, they run away.
Okay.
But grizzly bears, like, will come after you.
Mm.
And that's scary. That's why I always see these videos on TikTok of people chilling with bears, and I'm like, I don't get it.
Yeah.
If you had to rank your top movie you've seen in theaters so far this year, would it be Cocaine Bear?
Top movie I've seen this year. What all have I seen this year? I've seen Megan. Infinity Pool, Megan,
Ant-Man,
and this.
I think that's it.
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, this one was pretty fun. You know what I mean? This one was definitely probably the funnest.
That's sick.
You know what I mean? Megan was pretty good.
Yeah, Megan was
fun. Megan's the second runner-up.
And then Infinity Pool or Ant-Man?
No, both of those are
equal.
Both of those are equally. I'm unsure.
Fair. Like, I really want to see it. I need to see Infinity Pool.
Yeah, Infinity Pool. I don't know if I like it or hate it.
Fair.
I know I don't love it, but I can. I think I like it. You know, it's intriguing. You know what I mean? It's weird, but Cocaine Bear is amazing. Cocaine Bear is really funny. They do some great shit. It's a really funny bunny. Like, Elizabeth Banks really killed it, like, as a director. Like, the way they edited the movie was amazing. Like, I think they did really nail it. Like,
I'm excited to go
I
see it.
I would go see it.
I'm excited to go see
it. Yeah. Catch it at least on a, you know, $5 Tuesday or something. I'll go see it again. You
bet.
Know?
I'll let you know. $5 Tuesday would be good.
Hell yeah.
I want to see Creed 3, too, at some point.
Yeah, I'm trying to see that probably this weekend.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you going to skip 1 and 2?
Fuck yeah.
You're just going to watch 3?
Yeah.
No, you got to watch 1 and 2.
What?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Then you'll appreciate 3 more.
No, because then I'll watch 3 and be like, I'm going to go back.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. All right. Go ahead. That's fine. I'm sure that everything will... I mean, it won't be that much things.
And then I'll be able to watch 3 again, like, after I rewatch it. You know what I mean? Like, if I really love it all, I'll get 3 when it comes out. And
it's hard for me to imagine you not loving it.
Yeah, I've heard really good things about it.
Like, people are excited about John Wick 4, but I'm excited about Creed 3.
John Wick is trash. Ass.
Yeah, I haven't seen 2 or 3. It's like one that I don't think I quite get. That might be our movie club hot take.
John Wick is ass. You agree with me? John Wick is ass?
I just think it's probably closer to mid than people give it credit for. At least the first one. I haven't seen 2 and 3.
Okay. Hell yeah. I'm glad you agree with me on that. Yeah. That movie's ass.
No beef on that today.
Oh, man.
Speaking about beef.
Beef?
This isn't even beef. I was going to say, speaking about things that aren't mid.
What?
What'd you think of that last Abbott Elementary episode? And not the one that was today, but the...
It just fucked me up. You know, we were just, you know, I'll spoil it. Spoil the behind the scenes, but we're talking about it. But
this is
like
a spoiler for Abbott, too.
Yeah, of course. But I knew this was going to happen, too, just because I was rewatching. Ian hasn't seen since the break came back. So we watched Valentine's Day last night. And then it was like, I'm like, oh, yeah, I need to rewatch everything after the break. Because I've seen everything up until the break. I was just rewatching, like, Abbott over and over again. Speaking of, I got Abbott on DVD last night.
That's lit.
Yeah. I was here with no Wi-Fi for days watching Community again. Community gets better every time.
Dude, I just did a Community rewatch. And, like, the older you get, the more you appreciate certain things.
Community gets better every time.
And, like, the characters work for so many different, like, plot lines. I don't know. For just so many different types of humor.
Yeah. The writing of that is insane.
Yeah. It's really, really impressive.
Everything about it is insane. But yeah, I was just thinking about all the DVDs I wanted. I'm like, I would watch Peacemaker right now. I laid here the first night, right? And I had all this shit in here, you know, and I didn't have a bed or anything, so I slept right here on the couch. And then I was just laying over, like, a big plastic tub full of Blu-rays.
Uh-huh.
And I was just like, and I couldn't decide on anything until I saw Mean Girls. And I was like, yeah, Mean Girls is the one.
Hey, it's lit.
But then I just started thinking about I'm like, what would I watch right now? I'm like, I'd watch Abbott.
I've been thinking about maintaining a more better physical collection of things.
It's nice. It kind of, it comes in handy at certain times like that, you know, but.
By physical collection, too, I mean a nice hard drive with all of them digitally. Of course, legally obtained.
But how, all right, I have, like, a huge digital collection. Like, how, I don't even think there's a way I could, like.
Oh, I guess I was talking about, I used to torrent things a bunch.
That's not legally obtained.
I winked.
What?
I winked.
No. Yeah, you know, I was thinking, like, there was a joke, too, about something about torrenting coming back. Like, what happened recently? There was something.
I think it, like, just with things being taken off of services.
True.
People are like, well, this is literally the only way I can watch this now. I think that's a big part of it.
Yeah. Damn.
Like, there's that Mrs. Fletcher show. I didn't even realize some of the HBO Max stuff is, like, gone for good. Like, Mrs. Fletcher.
You know what I used to do all the time, too?
Huh.
The DVD players that used to be, they used to play, like, MP4s. And you could put an MP4 on a CDR.
Yep.
So you could buy a stack of CDs.
Yep.
And then just burn movies onto them. Most movies fit on one disc. Some movies fit on two if they're really, really long. But.
And then you go get a library card, and then you start using the library's DVDs to do that.
They're DVDs.
The library's got DVDs.
They give you blank DVDs?
No, but like you could use the DVD, like rent the DVD and then make a copy of it.
Yeah. They used to be those, yeah, or like that thing you just put it in your computer and
it'd play
through it once. And crazy times.
Crazy times.
I used to do that too. We used to get Redbox and Netflix DVDs all the time and just copy them on the computer.
Hey, it's lit.
Damn, I'm just admitting to all these crimes right now.
Well, you know what the real crime is how much these subscription services are taking our money and also taking out their content.
And it was at least like 10, 15 years ago I was doing that shit.
Yeah, we're good. We're not alone in it.
Yeah.
Yeah,
but Abbott Elementary, I do not like fully remember. You know, like I...
Much like Barbara like and...
It literally, I watched it. Me and Peyton were watching it, and it was just like... I was just like, I'm so excited to talk about this on the pod. Like, this is the juiciest episode it's been.
Dude, do you want me to go through? Let's just go through the moments.
Yeah. So
Barbara and redheaded teacher. Why can't I think of her name?
Melissa.
Melissa and Barbara got lit and drunk and had the confrontation with her sister.
Okay.
And like kind of made up.
Gregory wasn't supposed to be there.
He was supposed to go on a trip.
Amber broke
and he was like, I planned this whole thing. It's going to be so awesome. And Janine is like, wow, that sounds awesome.
Yeah.
And then
April was like, I'm trying to like
do nothing.
Yeah.
Which I get.
True.
What kind of vacation person do you like to? Do you like to do nothing or would you like to have things planned out?
Honestly, I mean, I'm not into, like, doing, like, everything, like, the city has to offer. But I'm trying to go out and do nothing, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
I'm trying to go see some place. I'm trying to go see some cool place and sit there for a few hours, enjoy that I've never seen.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm trying to go eat some food. Then I'm trying to go, you know, I don't know.
I like to, like, aimlessly walk around cities.
Yeah, me too.
Like, go to their park.
Yeah.
Or, like, just walk till I get food.
Yeah, exactly.
That's nice.
Just
to me.
Find some cool little shop too along the way. You yeah. know, like
if there's a cool museum, yeah. I'll go to the museum.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like to do stuff definitely, but I like do really want like a lazy vacation soon. I want to do something dumb, like go to the beach somewhere and just
and
do
just
like
do beach all day.
Yeah, or like a cruise yeah. or some shit. You know, like
cruises can be nice. Yeah. Well, the real I like when you can find a good you can find good deals on like the all inclusive ones, not like White Lotus level, but yeah. those can be nice because then you just. You
that's
just
what
get
I'm
up
saying.
Food all day.
I want to. That's what I think I want to do soon, like for a vacation. Like I haven't done a real vacation. Like me and Lewis went to New York, like, you know what I mean, in 2017 or whatever, you know, and like that was like my last like vacation.
For you went to that ski resort, right?
Yeah, I guess that was a little vacation too. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm hating on that, but
no, I get it though
because that was amazing. But
nah, I feel it. We'll get a movie club pod on a. We'll put it on the company card.
yeah. yeah. Wouldn't that be something?
so then Jeffrey was there. Not Jeffrey. Gregory.
Jeffrey, come on. Speaking of, Bel Air is back, but I haven't watched it.
I saw that it's back because I've been watching. What have I been watching on Peacock? Poker Face. And obviously Janine's there, but now she's hanging out with Gregory because Gregory's there. And yep. then what's oh my gosh, what's white dude's name?
Jacob.
Why am I blanking all the names today?
I don't know.
Jacob was hanging out with those other teachers and he was killing it.
Yeah.
And then he was like.
And one of them is the girl that kicked the student at the very beginning, too. That's the funniest part.
Oh my gosh, I knew I recognized her, but I couldn't put my finger on it.
Yeah, that was her. Because she went to that other like charter school. They saw her whenever they had to return those books.
Was she the one that was getting a little tipsy?
Yeah.
That's funny.
Yeah.
That's funny. I like when he was like, whoa. They end up being kind of shitty people. I forgot what they said at the end.
Yeah, I don't.
They said something crazy about like funding.
Yeah, I don't remember that arc completely at all. But
now we know that there's a little plot point at the end too that someone's trying to maybe buy out Abbott.
Yeah, see, I gotta rewatch this episode. I'm trash. I'm
Melissa's
trash today
sister
on the
like bus. Shows up to the school to like give Melissa the information about it.
Oh yeah,
and then
Janine's
like, oh. Hey, Melissa's sister.
Yeah. she's like, don't tell anyone I was here. Oh.
Yeah. Janine's like, hey.
So good.
So good.
So good. Yeah,
you know,
I love it.
You know what Janine was in? She was in the first episode of, I don't know if you ever watched it, but Party Down.
No,
has
I
come
haven't.
Back.
That's got someone in it. Who?
It's Adam Driver, or not Adam Driver, Adam Scott, Martin Starr.
Martin Starr, yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't know it's Adam Scott.
Yeah. And, that the principal from Glee.
I never seen Glee.
You know what I'm talking about, though?
No.
She's like short, blonde hair. You'd recognize her, I'm sure.
Okay.
But it's a funny little cast. It's a weird little show. Each episode's like a different place that they're catering.
Okay.
And they're all like burnt out Hollywood people that are like want to be actors and writers, but they work as caterers.
That sounds interesting. I like Adam Scott enough too that. Yes. Like, he's funny. Like, I like seeing him in different shit.
Yeah, and Martin Starr's hilarious, too.
Yeah.
Kyle Martin Starr.
Yeah, Martin Starr is pretty funny.
You current on The Last of Us?
No. You watched this week?
Yeah.
I know Storm Reed's in it. I know it's a flashback episode of Ellie.
Yeah. It ends on a cliffhanger, you know. I think the other girl is probably immune, too. That's my theory.
Storm?
Yeah. She's immune. I know it. They wouldn't do this to me. I think this show has a real issue with letting gay people live.
What?
You know?
What?
In episode 3, they both died.
Oh. Who else is dead that's gay?
Isn't the one girl end up? They get bit.
Yeah.
I'm assuming she's not immune like Ellie.
Yeah. They're just killing all the gays. They're getting back for White Lotus. It's HBO doing.
It's a balancing act.
Yeah.
Oh.
Actually, wait, she murdered all them too. Never mind. Never mind. Oh. I was just thinking of these gays are trying to kill me, and then I was like, yeah, like Last of Us is getting back for that quote, but like she got back before.
That's funny.
Never mind, yeah.
That's funny. It's been good though. Last of Us has been really good. The sets have been the craziest part, I think, to me.
Yeah. Like, I mean, this is early too. I know like I'm behind, but like yeah, like even just seeing them like walk through the little watery, like when she was just doing like the concierge shit, you know what I mean? Like that was like episode 2, you know what I mean? That was still with Tess, I think, you know, yeah. But like just that set alone, I'm like that's dope. That feels cool, you know, like
when like they did a whole mall. They made a whole mall.
Yeah.
But I think the way that they were able to do it was the same way that 8 Crazy Nights was able to do it. Had all those brand names in it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Where it, like, works because it's a mall. Yeah, they also, like, it's probably product placement.
HBO has a problem with Starbucks, all right? like they got a real problem with Starbucks because they were talking about that in one of the episodes. Like, oh, yeah, like, the Starbucks at the fucking, at the quarantine zone. Yeah. It's like, yo, that's crazy.
That is funny.
They got an issue with Starbucks.
Dude, HBO's been on a run, though, man.
Wait a minute. We got to talk about HBO today.
All right, let's talk about it.
We got to talk about HBO today. You didn't hear about the Rolling Stone article?
Oh, man, I was gonna make a nice segue into...
I ruined
From Last of Us into Euphoria.
Well, we're not talking about Euphoria.
Into Sam Levinson.
We're talking about the idol, yeah.
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 It's kind of wild. I can't believe how The Weeknd responded to the whole thing.
Yeah, that I mean that's pretty much the end of it all. But did you read that article?
I've read highlights of it on Twitter.
Okay.
Like
it's a long ass article.
Yeah, yeah. I know what like the backstory is and like yeah. the juice and the word on the street is about the idol.
Yeah, it's pretty insane. Like and a lot of people are like there's so many weird little claims too, like about what's going on and like you know, like I don't know, like
well, like, the one thing that definitely points to it being, like, probably true is the amount of people that left the set with it still, like, not finished. So that points to it, like, being probably something that's real.
Well, it's cut off twice, you know what I mean? Like, it started filming once with a different director.
Yeah.
You know, and then Sam Levinson came in. And,
it also just makes Sam Levinson look kind of bad. Yeah. And, like, some of the Euphoria complaints about him being maybe yeah. more real.
Yeah, apparently the whole story's changed. Apparently he didn't come in until, like, the day Lily Rose was, like, shooting her first intimate scene. It was, like, 4 weeks into set filming. Yeah.
That's weird.
Yeah.
That's weird.
Like multiple people claim that like, that was his first day.
Weird.
And it's, like, yeah, it's just kind of...
The one thing that...
The Weeknd is, you know, kind of, like, has had... You know, they were saying he was, like, upset about how much of a... feminist view it was being written in.
Weird.
And he like made his character more prevalent and
yeah, I'm interested to see how the show ends up. Someone made a really good point about Sam Levinson in that like Ruse episode, which is written by Hunter and directed by Hunter.
Is like what the bonus episode yeah, after season
is
one?
Is like maybe like one of the most like powerful episodes.
Yeah.
And it like has nothing to do like he was you know,
yeah,
like,
oh, yeah.
It's like what happens when you strip him away from the equation.
Yeah.
I would almost be more interested in season 3 if, like, Rue directed it. Or if they all directed an episode each. Like, I think that would go off.
Yeah, see, me and Ian were just talking outside. And I'm like, they were also talking about how the vibe of the idol set, whenever it was, like, towards the end, was Sam Levinson... was giving off the vibe of, if HBO wants a season 3, they're going to let me do whatever I want with this. And now at this point, like, executives don't even, like, people don't know what the final cut of this thing is looking like. People don't know when it's releasing. It's kind of crazy. But I was thinking, I'm like, who the fuck, I'm like, you know, people were even comparing him to, like, Josh Whedon. Like, this is why people like Josh Whedon can run around Hollywood and shit, you know, like. But it's like, who the fuck this is to say, like, yeah, he can't just be replaced with someone, you know, like. Euphoria season 3 easily could go on. I'm like, season 2 was kind of a disaster.
Yeah, and I mean, like, honestly, there are other factors that are more important than him.
Yeah.
For I'm like, Euphoria, like, Zendaya. Yeah. Like, I'm sure she, if she wanted to, be like, we don't want him on this. Yeah. Like, I'm not coming back if he's on this.
But that's the other thing, too, is that a lot of people have, like, supported him low-key.
Yeah, and it's hard to tell, of course, like, coming from an outsider's perspective who was just reading articles about it. Like, I don't want to project how I feel sort of about his directing compared to, like, how the other people feel about his directing.
Yeah.
But, I mean, like, it's crazy. Like, this show is big, I feel like, because of the actors.
Yeah.
And not because of how incredible, like, the season two writing was at times. Even though, like, there was some great moments.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like it could have been even better.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's, like, crazy. Yeah, like, I'm sure, like, HBO owns Euphoria at the end of the day.
Is the Idol come out after Succession or with Succession?
No one knows when the Idol's coming out.
Like, okay. So I was going to say, the HBO is on, like, one of the greatest runs of TV history, I think. Not TV history, but in a long time. Going from House of the Dragon into White Lotus into The Last of Us into Succession Season 4.
Yeah, I mean, and Euphoria Season 2, start of the year.
Oh, my gosh. What was over the summer, too? Something in between. I need to look at it, because they might be... This run might have been going on for a minute longer than this.
Yeah.
It's been a good... And I like every week to week, watching is cool with me.
Yeah.
Even though now I'm realizing, because I got stars for Party Down, I'm like, ah, I'm going to have this now for, like, 12 weeks or whatever, 10 weeks.
Yeah.
It's like, I was like, they've got me.
Yeah. That's the shitty thing about streaming services sometimes.
It's going to be like that, except I still have 3 months of free Apple TV left from when I upgraded my phone.
Yeah, mine just ran out. I started paying for it. I had to cancel my news. I had my little free news.
Nice. But I'm excited to have it for Ted Lasso, baby.
Yes.
Did you watch that new trailer?
Of course, man. That trailer made me tear up.
Yeah.
Like, the first time I saw it, I was like, let's fucking go. Like, that was the best piece of marketing they could have done. They barely did anything. That's how you promote a show.
Wait, did you watch the second trailer?
Oh.
There's a second one.
There's a second one. I was going to look at the HBO shows real quick of what came out.
Pull it up.
Winning Time.
I don't know that one.
That was the Lakers show.
Oh, yeah.
Winning Time was last year.
That one's pretty good.
Yeah.
I don't know what else would have been in there.
Barry. Oh, Righteous dude. Gemstones.
Both of those are great. Barry is so good.
Yeah. The Rehearsal.
Oh, yeah. They really have been on another level.
Yeah. They did the Gerard Carmichael. Ooh, he's got an untitled docuseries coming.
That's going to be great. You just know it.
Shout out that. What were we saying before that?
Ted Lasso.
Oh, Ted Lasso season two.
Season three.
Sorry. I just started watching it again.
It's a pretty close to the other trailer, but there's just like more clips.
Oh.
It's not that long, though.
All right, well. You can't always get what you want.
The good old stadium. He's in the window now.
Alone in the window.
Sacrifices. They all look so serious there.
I know. Jamie Tart looking humble this season.
Vibe shift. Things are seeming better now. That was a weird clip right there. I want to talk about that after.
Oh, what?
It feels like they're about to ask Jamie something. Like, go back a little more.
She's pregnant.
Maybe. What if it's Jamie's?
Ah!
That's so funny.
I love you guys so very much.
On three. One, two, three.
I love you guys so very much.
Great job.
Oh, Rock Kent just said great job.
Oh, yeah.
That's where, like, the highlight to the wit comes in Ted Lasso is, where it's just, like, the three coaches on the sideline just saying things.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, him and Beard are so good. It's just, like, I was just thinking about just rewatching it. Like, that show gets better and better, too. But
yeah. The little lines they slip in.
They're, like, at the very beginning, too, when they're talking to Nate, and they're, like, what? They're, like, he's, like, what? Speak up. He's, like, if you're not very confident. He's, like, I can't hear unconfident voices very well. And then He's like, do you think that play will work? And he's like, yes, I think it'll work. And then he's like, whoa. And then they both just, like, drop to the floor. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like,
just, like, him and Beard's coordination on things.
Yeah, I know. It's brilliant.
Oh, it's so good. I'm excited for that. That's going to be a spark of joy.
Yeah, I can't wait. It's the best show.
It is.
It's the one.
I hope. I wouldn't be mad if they kept going, but if it's an ending, I hope it's a good ending.
I mean, I want it to end.
I want it to end on the right note.
I want it to end this season,
I
but they're not saying that, so I don't think it is.
I personally think four is like the GOAT TV length, I think.
Yeah.
Like, Succession's going to wrap up with four seasons.
Yeah. Like, I think they might lose. Like, that trailer was way too set up for them to win. Like, they can't, like, I don't know, like.
Yeah, that looks sad.
The trailer's way too set up for them to win.
You can't always get what you want, but if you try so hard, you might find you get what you need.
Exactly. Nate's gonna win.
I would kind of love that. It was funny to see Ted and his kid and Beard in the stands watching Nate coach. Like, of course that's what he would do, you know? Like, he's, of course.
Yeah.
Oh, we gotta go support him. Gotta support the boy.
Yeah.
I'm excited for that, man.
Yeah, I can't wait. It's in less than 2 weeks.
That's so wild. I feel like so many movies are coming out. Or TV shows are starting that week.
What else?
Yellow Jackets? Something else might start too that week.
That shit ended so badly.
Give it hope.
It ended so badly.
I have hope. Maybe all that was all a dream.
It better be.
What else? I feel like tonight there's so much music coming out.
What?
But also just might be, like, littler acts that I'm excited for.
What?
Well, remember that one Menthol song I showed you?
Maybe.
She has a new song coming out.
I'll know it if I heard it.
She has a new song coming out, and I'm excited for that. I'm sure that there's other ones. I just can't think of the ones.
That was the only song, and you said there's so much music coming out?
I feel like there's other things. I just can't remember them now. I'm under pressure.
Oh, damn.
Too much pressure, and I'm nervous. And the taxi cab puts on the radio.
Yeah.
Bro, speaking of back throwback songs, how about those throwback songs in the movie you watched this week?
That was bad.
I know. I was trying to think of a great
speaking
one.
Speaking of those throwback songs.
I was going to say at one point, I was like, oh, you saw Ted Lasso with his boy in the crowd. Speaking of boys in crowds with their fathers, what did you think of the movie this week?
Oh, Stevie, you're losing your touch. You're off your game in the new spot. We'll get it back.
You know what used to rock? School. Speaking of School of Rock, the movie watched this week was directed by that guy.
All right. God damn it.
What do you mean by that?
Give me a fucking break, buddy.
Oh, shit. Here we go again.
It's still Before Midnight. Speaking of Before Midnight, this movie this week was directed by that
Wait,
guy.
He did Before Midnight.
Yeah, did Before Sunrise and those ones too.
Yeah. Why wasn't Ethan Hawke in School of Rock? That's the real question.
That's true.
Didn't Richard Linklater do Almost Famous?
Maybe. I'm not sure. Did Dazed and Confused though?
Yeah, he did Almost Famous.
I think Richard Linklater is, and that's who directed the movie this week. The movie this week was Boyhood.
Boyhood.
I think Richard Linklater is one of the best American filmmakers.
Yeah, he might be.
But he doesn't really do, like, the whole blockbuster thing, usually. But, and I think that's what makes it great.
But they feel so mainstream. I was so amazed by how mainstream this felt. You've told me about this movie a million times. And when I started, I was like, wow, this just, like, feels, like, fun already. Just, like, that classic. Just every music choice at the beginning. You know, every throwback song.
So the movie, the premise is over 12 years, they met once a year and filmed, like, a scene or like a few scenes. And they use the same actors to play each part throughout the whole thing. The sister was his daughter.
It started in 2002.
Yeah, the sister was his daughter.
Good guess here.
And Ethan Hawke was in it. I forgot what the mom's name is.
Patricia Arquette.
Great actor.
So good.
And it just follows. It's just like a little slice of life. You know, like his parents are divorced and the mom has some rocky relationships. I don't know. Just a lot of slice of life stuff.
Yeah, it transitions very interestingly where it isn't a structure. It just just entertains you throughout their life, you know, at very interesting moments. And
it just like happened to line up with our years. Like, so like when he was that age, that's what we are.
Really?
Yeah.
So
maybe like 1 year
younger.
Yeah, but
no, I mean, he's like six at 2002. So like, I mean, but that's just still pretty fucking close.
Yeah. It just hit me so hard when like that Soulja Boy crank that remix come on.
The Ripstick too in the background too. That was the cool, like instantly I saw the second he started playing the Game Boy, you know, and then it very quick, you know, after like it transitioned like once and then you see him playing an Xbox.
And then he's like sitting there watching YouTube videos.
Yeah.
Or like the time where like you would just watch the same YouTube videos over and over again.
And yeah, someone's like, you're really watching that again.
It was the Will Ferrell like, give me my money.
I've never even seen that.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I've only seen it like once or twice.
Yeah, but I've seen memes of it, I feel like, on Twitter, you know. But yeah, it was so good in that aspect. They really like every moment of this movie was so real feeling. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Nothing felt like acting. You
or
know, I don't know.
Dramatized, like it felt authentic.
Yeah, you know, like and the way they did, like even just down to like the boys just breaking wood in the house that's like being partially built. You know what I mean? Like that. That's just like what you would do. You know what I mean?
Yeah, and like how the dynamic of like the older brother and the friends like picking on the one friend.
Exactly. Yeah.
And, like you trying to like hold your own against them.
Yeah. You know, there was so much to that. Like
the one kid did kind of flame him back pretty good where he was like why are you here? So cool, why are you hanging out with eighth graders?
Yeah, so many different moments like that. You know, so many just seeing how the kids acted and all this too. Like, you know, every different kid felt like, you know, like, oh, I know all these kids. You know, like
when they're playing the Wii boxing together.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they just very quickly. It's like, you know, that was like the first day of them like living there too. You know, like in that random new house.
Well, no, it's so great too because you see not only, you know, like the main character Mason grow, but like Ethan Hawke's character and the mom grow. And go through so many different things. Like, Ethan Hawke's character starts off being, like, such a drifter kind of piece of shit. But then by the end of it, like, he's a really solid dude. And he's been a really solid dad the whole time.
Yeah.
Just maybe not as, like, obviously involved in the life because they're separated.
Yeah.
But every time he's there, he's always giving him good advice.
Yeah. No, he was. He was, like, a good dad in those scenes.
You don't want the gutters. Life doesn't give you – you don't want the bumpers. Life doesn't give you bumpers. It seems like a dick thing to say, but that's, like, good advice.
Yeah. No, he was dope.
And then he's, like, sitting there being like, who are you voting for in the next election?
Them going around with the Biden-Obama signs, too, was hilarious. He's like, rip up that McCain. He's like, grab it. And he's like, what? He's like, no, grab it now.
Dude, she goes, he had a Confederate flag in his front yard. He's like, what does that mean?
Yeah.
Do I look like an Obama supporter?
He's like, I could shoot you right now. Get off my lawn.
Yeah. And then the one lady was like, that's so awesome. That's so great.
She's like, I made these shirts, Mama for Obama.
But then, like, I don't know. There's so many great lighthearted moments. But then the movie gets, like, I don't know, heavy at times, too.
Yeah, it gets pretty, like, you know, it gets heavier at the end, you know, of course.
The first dad really, I don't know, this time was really unsettling for me. I think, like, when I first saw the movie, I, like, was, I think, like, a sophomore in, like, 21, 22. So, like, I really resonated with, like, Mason and, like, Mason's progression into himself. But now that I'm watching it, like, a little bit older, like, I really resonate with, like, the mom and the dad a little bit more.
Yeah.
Or just maybe all of it.
Yeah.
And just being like, damn, I understand how she, like, slipped into that relationship. And, like, I get how hard that had to be to get out. But there's some moments that you're like, oh, like, when she's on the ground and you don't know how she got there.
Oh, I mean, I knew exactly.
And then, like, the throwing of the glass stuff.
Yeah, that was crazy. Like, that's, I mean, that's a fucked up part. Like I said, I don't know. I felt like this was my life. Like, I, like, moving so much as a kid, like, I felt that, you know what I mean? Like, I, you know, I, my, like, my mom dated people. Like, I've lived with, like, I've had, like, stepbrothers for, like, 6 months.
Damn.
You know, like,
yeah.
And then it just didn't work out, you know, and then we're gone. And it's like, that's wild, you know? Like,
yeah, you had that moment where they were like,
yeah.
Are we ever going to see them again?
She's yeah.
Like, I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, it wouldn't even really like that either, you know what I mean? It was just different, you know, but, like, you know, like, but, yeah, you know, that's happened to me a couple times, you know, and I don't know, it's crazy. It's funny seeing, like, not funny, but it's wild seeing, like, the different types of boyfriends, too, like, dealing with, like, a single mom type shit, like, that shit hits so, like, hits at home so hard, you know what I mean? But it's, like, interesting, like, because they always show Mason noticing it every time, too. He was always, like, the one noticing when the guy liked her. You know what I mean? Like, instantly. And I think his little manager at the end was like, oh, that's your mom?
Yeah.
I think he was about to be the next one. They just never... That might be in manhood.
Maybe. Maybe in manhood. I love that, like, the pacing of this movie. Because, you know, like, a lot of movies, they follow, like, a structure of, like, you know, like, there's the beginning part, the climax. You know, like, the different momentums. But this is just kind of like a breeze.
Yeah.
And there are, like, those peak dramatic moments, like, when they're finally getting away from that first dad and, like, the second dad.
And it, like, feels like life. It feels like a journey. You know, even just thinking about where Ian left off in the movie, because Ian was watching it with me for, like, you know, up until, you know, they were still kid. You know, they're still real young for the most part, because it was, like, a good portion of being young, and then started moving a little faster, or it felt like it, at least.
It feels like it. It feels like it.
Yeah. It's, there's, like, those puberty years where, like, dude just, like, jumps up real quick, or, like, you know, his voice changes one transition real quick.
Yeah.
Like,
oh, man. And there's something I think that everybody can connect to.
Yeah.
And there's, like, little slices of life that just make me think about things differently, or just make me feel, like, less alone in going through it.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, when he has to get his hair cut and he's, like, pissed off about that.
Yeah.
I'm like, damn, I feel for you. Like, yeah. I get that. Or even, like, when he's in the dark room and, like, the teacher's giving him, like, trying to give a motivational talk.
I fucked with that teacher, though, low-key. But that teacher was, like, a sergeant about it, but, like...
It's one of those things... It reminded me of, like, a lesser severe version of, like, the Whiplash guy. But, like, you kind of need... Everyone has those moments, I feel like, where, like... Being like, I see a lot of potential in you, but, like, you gotta figure out how to harness this shit.
I think he did. I think that teacher did it better than, like, most people do it in real life. Like, you know, obviously it was written.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Well,
but
he never,
like,
said, like, you can't do art.
Yeah.
He just gave.
That's what I'm saying. And he straight up said, he's like, I think you're so talented. You know what I mean? He said, you know, I don't know. I feel like that's, like, you know, and I feel like he was, like, you know, like, responsive to that. You know, he said it a little aggressively, but he said it, like, you know, not just, like, I think you're talented. You know what I mean? He said it, like, a lot more than that, you know.
And it got him to go shoot more.
Yeah.
I love his little journey into becoming a photographer.
Yeah, that was interesting.
That was
cool. I wonder if they, like, play into, like, his interest. I wonder if that, like...
I think a part of it might have been Richard Linklater, like, writing about himself somewhat, too.
Yeah. No, I mean, I knew there had to be some elements to that.
I also loved that the dad's friend, like, this is, like, a little detail, but, like, the dad's friend is now, like, kind of popped off. Like,
that was,
like,
dope. That
he,
was,
like,
a really
stuck with it, and, like...
That was a cool payoff at the end, like...
All the payoffs are so cool. There's, like, a bunch of little payoffs that you're just like, how did they do this?
Yeah.
And, like, you were mentioning it off on camera, but I love him when he, like, brings the kid over, and he has, like, the weed up, and he's like, ah!
No, that felt like... Just that whole thing felt like every place my dad's ever lived at.
Interesting.
Like... That's like, so funny. I remember going to my dad's for the weekends and just being at, like, the cool apartment, you know what I mean, with video games and fucking a pool table or, like, a guitar and an amp, you know, and, like, oh, no, like, it was just...
Yeah.
Yeah, that scene, I love that, especially when they started playing the music and shit, too.
Yeah.
He had, like, the little Fender Rhodes or some shit in the background. Like,
yeah, the song was, like, a little bit too, like, Like I would have, if I was the kid, I would have felt weird. But it was
a
good song.
I know, but that's like that's also the beauty of like the writing of that scene.
Yeah.
Of like being like a struggling musician. You know what I mean? Like you put your heart and soul into music. You know what I mean? And like, and you want to speak your truths and shit too. And like, I don't know. Like that scene, I was like, holy fuck, that'd be me if I was like a dad right now. Maybe just being like. You know, and I'm going through all that, you know, like...
And it was, like, very, like, clear that he's trying to, like, connect with his kids.
Yeah, you know, like...
I loved how much effort he put into trying to be...
Yeah.
...a good dad. And, like, at first, you know, he thinks about being a good dad as, like, taking the kids bowling and bringing them gifts. And
yeah.
And eventually, like, you know, leads into being, like, no bullshit, like, what's up with your life?
Yeah, yeah.
And I like that.
Yeah. Yeah, the whole time he was on that. And yeah, it's funny. It takes him some time to, like, mature, you know what I mean? And it's, like... It was interesting to me how, like, positive everybody was about, like, him starting the new family, kind of. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I feel like that, like, a lot of times, like...
Can go sour.
Yeah, it can, like, cut deep sometimes to people. You know what I mean? Like...
We gave him a gun for his birthday. That was
yeah,
so funny.
Yeah, and the grandma with the Bible with, like, yeah. The, you know...
Was I baptized?
And that was funny because they were joking outside, and she's like, I can hear you. You know, he's like, yeah, he's like... You know, her parents are religious. And
oh, and then the little moment with the mom and the manager of the restaurant, that's really powerful.
Yeah,
to me.
That was super dope. That was the best payoff.
Yeah, you know? And then, I feel so bad for the mom at the end. Like, that feels so real and so painful where she's just, like, she's having, like, an existential crisis.
Yeah.
And it's like, damn. Like, I don't know. That hurts. I get her pain. But I mean, like, she's starting to do chapter two. I think it's just, like, one of those, like, the opposite page of a new chapter sometimes feels, like, a little bit, like, scary and daunting.
Yeah. No, that scene was crazy, and it just, yeah, just...
Because he's, like, he has unlimited, you know, like, his future in front of him, and she feels like her future's behind her.
Yeah.
He's like, Mom, I think you were like 40 years too early on.
Which is also like, wait, is it 40? Like, how old is she actually?
I think she's probably 40.
Yeah, so it might be like, you know, should be like a good like 50, 60, you know, hopefully.
Yeah. Oh, man. And the music choices are so good. Like, Yellow to start it out with was so nice.
Yeah.
And he's just like laying in the grass.
Yeah.
What did he say? Like, I think wasps come from throwing the rocks. And I was like, that's such like
throwing
a...
water.
Yeah. Oh, and then, like, the little kids finding the magazine, that felt like childhood. Not childhood, but, like...
No, everything about it, yeah. I mean, I almost forget about all of it. It's like, cool because it feels like life because you almost, like, forget about the childhood, like, and...
Yeah.
You know, and, like...
I don't know if you, like, the... When she's like, oh, he hit me, and she's faking it, that to me was like, oh, man, that was my childhood.
Yeah. See, I didn't know the sibling element of any of that, you know what I mean? But, like... I know if my dad watched that movie, that'd be, like, one of his favorite movies. And I know, you know, he would feel like that was, you know what I mean? That, I don't know. But, like, but the sibling thing is the one thing that, like, also, like, separates me from it, too. Because it's, like, yeah, I never had a sibling or anything, but.
Yeah. I also love the dad's music taste. Like, that Wilco song where he's, like, I try to stay busy. That's a song that I actually like. But I feel it's so funny because that's how I would describe the song. It's just straight up production. Abbey Road Beatles. Yeah. I was like, that's something that I would say now. I also, like, very much so related to, like, him and that one girl who he had a good connection with in high school. But then she, like, went the, like, basic preppy route, if that makes sense.
What, like,
the college lacrosse dude?
Yeah.
I was like, oh, I get that.
Yeah, I mean, I related to that conversation they had outside, not specifically what happened, but, like, that just felt so real to me, and it's like, oh, my God, like, the...
I only told Becky.
And especially being younger, too, it's like, yeah, you think I haven't been seeing anybody, too? Like, and then they're just like, you're just saying that to hurt me, and just run off, and it's like, you're fucking trash still, though, like, I don't know, and you just feel salty, but then it's like, but that's also, like, a high school way of, like, you know, it just ends salty sometimes like that. I don't know.
The dad gave some good advice, too, after that. Yeah. And that was sick. He won that photo contest, and that was nice.
Yeah.
Even though it was a picture of her.
Yeah, I didn't even put that together.
Yeah. The night they had in Austin was cool, though. That made me be like, maybe Austin's cooler than I think. Actually, Austin's a very cool town. I don't know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But yeah,
a lot of towns in Texas. Like, Dallas is cool.
The second.
I've never been to Houston.
The second stepdad, I like that he was like, he's like, I've been here before. I can put up with this bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. He stood up for himself a little bit more than he would have.
Yeah.
Even though that guy sucked.
Yeah, that guy sucked too, but it was also like, all right, he's like also kind of like minor compared to the other dude too. Like,
yeah.
You know, he was just dick verbally, you know what I mean? But like.
I think that dude probably had like some like unresolved trauma too that he was like not dealing with.
Well, and it was funny because like, wasn't he a cop at one point and then he was a corrections officer? Or was he just always a corrections officer? Because they made that very, like, that was a very distinctive thing after the argument outside where he was like, and then he just turns around and it says corrections on the back and it's like,
I wonder,
and he just sits there angry and you can tell it's like, okay, he's got a fucking shitty job. Like,
I think so. You know, like, when we first met him, he was a student that had come back from touring and maybe he had like stopped being a student and just took a job.
Yeah. I think at a certain point, I thought he was wearing a police badge at the kitchen table, like when everything was still kind of good.
That might have been the case too.
Yeah.
That might have been the case too.
And I think he became a corrections officer maybe like, and that's when he started like drinking more, you know, and.
Yeah. Finances started to get rough.
Yeah.
All that good stuff. But he wasn't as scary as that first dad. That first dad was messed up.
Yeah.
Oh definitely. My God. The scene where the dude's driving. I don't know how they shot that. But that was so stressful.
Yeah.
Where he, like, swerves into traffic.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that was fucked up.
That guy was fucked up.
Yeah.
And he started off so normal.
He was the weird professor that, like, hit on her, though, too.
That is true. That was weird.
Yeah. He was like, hey, so you think you can get a babysitter?
Yeah.
Like, after class, like, walking out after class. Like.
Oh. I love the comment where he was like, at the end, he's like, oh, it would have been, like, nice if you guys would have stayed together or something like that. Would have saved me from, like, a string of drunken assholes. And Ethan Hawke's like, you said it, not me. Like, I don't
know. Who said that?
The boy says that about, like, he's older now. Like,
yeah.
When he's, like, almost at the end, he, like, makes a comment about the string of, like, drunken asshole boyfriends.
Yeah.
And then, like, Ethan Hawke's like, you said it, not me. Like,
yeah.
I can't say that shit, but
yeah.
It's not my place, but yes.
It was so funny when the mom, like, came up to him and his new girl at the graduation party.
Like, she walks away and he goes, she's a bitch.
Yeah, but even what she was saying was hilarious, just as far as like, oh yeah, you found him at a good time, I guess. Like, you know, like, I don't know. She was ruthless, but.
And it was nice that he offered to pay. That was all very wholesome.
I don't think that was a wholesome moment.
You think that's nice?
It was nice, but it was one of those like, okay, like, you know, because he was like, you know, well, he was like, good job, you know, but then he was like, here, you know, and he didn't even have the money in his wallet, you know, that made it like even look a little bit worse, I think, but like, I think it was like a.
Yeah, I think he probably feels bad for all the stuff that she paid for over time.
Yeah, well, no, I think it was like a, yeah, like, I just, you know, I'll just give you money and you do, you know, you handle everything, you know what
I
mean?
Yes,
and
saying.
It was like a, oh, like, you know. This is just, you know, the only thing you would do is just.
Yeah. But I mean, it would have been worse if he would have done nothing.
True.
You know what I mean?
True.
His brother there, though, that was so awkward. He was like, make sure you wear protection for breakup sex. You can ask your dad about that one.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like, dude.
And then he's like, yeah. He's like, you end up with this.
Yeah. It's like, bro.
The brother was funny for a second there.
Oh, man. But this movie, it just feels so different than most movies. Like, there's no, like, panic or crises. Like, you're just, like, watching life unfold.
Yeah.
And that feels so weird. And cool at the same time.
Yeah, no, it's great.
Like, there's no movie where that it ages so naturally. And that is, it's so weird when he, like, pops up from being, like, teenage or, like, you know.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden he's grown. I think, like, the last time he's, like, a boy is when he's, like, walking with that girl. After he's like going from the school to see his mom because his sister didn't pick him up, and that girl who's like clearly like flirting with him, but like he's not picking up on it. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, but she also says another girl has a crush on him.
Yeah, but I also feel like that's like the classic grade school way of being like.
She also like used that at first to get him to say like, oh, like Leanne has a crush on you. Do you got a girlfriend?
Yeah, and like is like you should come to this party. Like Leanne wants you to be there.
Yeah,
but like I think she wants him to be. I don't know.
Yeah. Because he was making, I think he was like with her later on.
I think she's in the back seat of the car.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too.
When they're, he's like, "Do you have any gum?"
Yeah.
That was a funny moment when he walks in and she's like, "Are you drunk?" And
yeah.
Like, yeah. Yeah. He's like, "Yeah."
I'm gonna go to sleep now.
She was a good mom.
Yeah.
She was a good mom. It was cool that the mom that helped her move out of that bad situation was there at the graduation.
Yeah.
Like, that was tight.
Yeah.
That made me happy. And I think that was the same girl.
No, definitely.
Like, the daughter.
Yeah. Yeah, she's like, "I'm 13 now."
Yeah.
Yeah. I was wondering if we're going to see the stepkids again at a certain point.
But I feel like it's better that, like, it's more real that you never do, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
I also liked his one friend who, like, shows up at the graduation with him. He's in a few scenes. He's, like, the drummer in the band at the party.
Yeah.
That seemed like a cool party. I was like, I don't think I ever saw a party so chill at high school.
Yeah. I'm like, not a lot of people, like, did music in my high school, but there was, like, every once in a while a couple people, and they would do, like, a little backyard party. You know what I mean? It was kind of cool like that, but...
That's sick. That's sick.
But that was the closest, you know? I don't know.
Did you know that the moment they're at that baseball game, right? It was, I mean, like, obviously, that was a real baseball game.
Yeah,
I figured. Like, it wasn't planned that that home run was going to happen. So, like, that just got, like, lucky. They were just, like, shooting for that pitch, and, like, they hit a home run, and so they got a pan over and be like, it's like a home run. Like, that was a real reaction.
Yeah, yeah. That makes sense. That's dope.
I just blows my mind how well it all looked together despite being over 12 years.
Yeah.
Like, everything felt so modern.
Yeah.
And so full of life.
Well, I wonder if they did, like, shoot it on the same fucking camera.
I mean, they had to. Like, yeah, definitely.
And then if you think about it, it's, like, really, like, you know, that's like a one-week shoot week. You know?
Like, part of me thinks, like, it's kind of brilliant in the way that it's, like, if you get everyone on board, like, what, maybe you just have to get funding for, like, $50,000 a year?
Yeah.
I mean, actually, now that's sounding a lot. But, I mean, not even if you're, like, a big director, like, a $500,000 budget.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Or just get, you know, like, a full movie budget, but it's just allotted over time. Like,
yeah,
you only
exactly.
need, like, the chunk of it for this year, you know, like.
Yeah.
Yeah, they should do this more often, like, film movies over, like, 4 and 5 year times, you know, and let, you know, I don't know.
And it's fun because, like...
Maybe even the shows. Imagine if they started doing shows, because they have those issues with, like, Stranger Things and shit like that in Ozarks, like...
Yeah, they should just write in the years past.
Yeah, or just film, like, the entirety of the show, like, you know, I don't know, like...
Quickly?
Yeah, or, like, just, I don't know, before it's... I don't know. Or, go into years, like...
It'd be fun if, like, someone did, like, a 10-episode show, and each episode was a different year.
Yeah.
But then you have to wait so long. Like, it's a miracle that they got all these actors, no one dropped off or dropped out. And, I mean, I guess, like, the plan was, like, he would write or rewrite things to fit in, like, as it went on.
Yeah.
And I'm sure they had to adapt to different things. But it's a cool experiment, and I think it paid off really well. I mean, like, he kind of did the same thing with, or does the same thing with the Before movies, too.
Mm-hmm.
Where it's like...
Yeah, those take place over time.
Yeah, it's like the first one's when they meet, and then the second one's, like, years after when they were supposed to meet. They have a random encounter, and then it's like when they're an old couple, or a middle-aged couple.
But when you're a solidified director, you know, you got people that will probably be on board for that, you know? A lot of people have, like, their same crews that they work with a lot of times.
Yeah, I mean, like, and he's worked with Ethan a bunch.
Yeah, exactly, so...
Honestly, the most important was that boy...
And what's that?
The boy was probably the most important.
Yeah, you know, the boy, the mom, you know, Patricia Arquette being on board was huge.
It's cool that he got his daughter in it.
Yeah.
Like, that sounds fun.
Yeah. You know, and those are the main people, and he can cast new people for different years and have them come and go, and some stay, and some be for a couple years, and some not. And
yeah. It's cool that he captured, like, the political tensions at the time, too. Like, it feels like a time capsule in that way.
Yeah.
Like, everyone remembers Bush versus Obama.
Oh, it's a total time capsule, just from everything, you know, like...
Yeah. Like, the different technologies that start to pop up.
Because it does capture, like, even if you don't know the Game Boy era, you know you may know the Xbox era. Even if you don't know that, you know the Wii era.
Yeah.
You don't know that, you know, like...
Dude, I love his little conversation when they're driving to Austin, and he's talking about social media.
Yeah.
Like, that was cool.
Yeah.
He's like, I just don't want to live my life on a screen. I was like,
oh. Yeah, and it was funny, because he was talking about how, like, oh, like... Yeah, everyone fucking hated that dude after he deleted his Facebook, like, last year. You know what I mean? It was like he was just trying, you know, like, And I'm like, that's so funny, like, how, like, serious the internet was at a certain point, too. Like, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know. They nail so many things like that.
Dude, the one, he makes that, like, really, like, big, you know, like, deep thought statement or, like, monologue about how his conspiracy is that people realized it was too expensive to build a robot workforce. So they just, like, programmed people into becoming robots to, like, be the workforce.
Yeah.
I was like, damn.
Yeah, kind of.
I was like, this kid gets it.
Kind of hit that one on the head.
Yeah, it made me think. Not yeah. like
I've never wanted to be one of those, like, anti-society people, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But, like, that one did get me a little close to being like,
Yeah, and I'm not...
Yeah.
I'm not fully agree with... But, like, I think it's an interesting perspective.
No, definitely.
I liked how, like, anti or, like, anti-culture he was, or anti-mainstream.
Yeah.
Because it also felt like he was picking that up from his dad in a lot of ways.
Yeah.
Like, looked up to his
dad. Well, it
was
cool what he did pick up from his dad. That moment, oh my God, that's such a real moment, too, whenever the dad was like, I sold the GTO.
Dude.
And he was like, yo.
Dude, yes.
Like, that's such a real moment. Like, and that's such a funny thing how kids, like, will latch on to certain things, you know what I mean? Especially, like that one specifically being like, oh, third grade, you know, blah, 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 you told me. You know what I mean? Like, you latch on to something. You remember that forever. But then you also, like, it's funny probably watching that from two different perspectives because I can see it from both already. You know what I mean? But, like, if you're talking about you were, like, more Mason, like, maybe even the first time you didn't even understand Ethan Hawke's side, but then, like, now you do or something.
Yeah,
you know?
I get it.
Yeah, where it's, like, also it's, like, yo, like, I don't remember doing that. You know
well,
what I mean?
Also, like, you're my kid, but, like, you're not. Like, I'm a person, too.
Well, that I thought was, like, you didn't need to say all that.
Well, yeah, yeah. But I mean, but I just mean, like, just, yeah, yeah. like, when you're a kid, you're like, how would you not have seen this from my perspective?
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you see everything from my yeah. perspective. But, like, to be like, my bad. Like, I,
yeah, yeah.
you know, like, I was in my own world, too.
If anything, I think it would have been better to just be like, you know, like, hey, like, you know, like, sometimes you just forget, you know, sometimes you just say something in the moment, you know what I mean? Like, I was, you know, I was in that moment, I thought I would give it to you, and...
Yeah. I mean, I have a very specific memory of, like, when I was, like, probably 5 or 6, I was playing, like, soccer in the backyard, and I was, like, making bets, like, if I made it past my dad, if I would, like, get one, and I was, like, if I make it past on this one, it was, like, a sudden death. I was, like, you get me a Nintendo 64, and I made the shot. Never got that.
Yeah,
but I still remember it.
Yeah, yeah,
and I remember being like a little like salty about it. But I mean, looking back now, I'm like, yeah, like I get it.
That was a finesse. Yeah, you was trying to get a finesse, but
I was like, I don't know, the way in the moment, the way we were playing too. Like, I don't even think I was the one who offered up that bet. I don't know, but
yeah, he was like, let's bet on it, and you were like, yeah, N64, and he was like, yep.
The important takeaway now, like looking back, is like that, you know, like it. I don't know. The fact that we were, like, chilling. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I think that, like, even looking back is like, yo, we were at least hanging out. I don't know.
Yeah.
But that was a powerful moment.
Yeah.
And a very, like, authentic moment, I felt like.
Yeah.
I also like when they were, like, looking at the Lady Gaga video. And the, like, stepmom was like, and your mom lets you watch this?
Yeah.
Yeah, she likes it.
She was like, yeah. And I, at first I was like, damn, she's being judgmental. She, like, I guess she was kind of religious and you didn't even know that yet. But
yeah.
But she also was like, all right, then. She's like, is she playing anywhere? Oh, she's playing in Houston? We'll get you tickets.
Yeah, you know, and I thought that was cool.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it also goes to show you, like, maybe how wild Lady Gaga was in that moment.
Yeah.
Because, like, for us, it was just, like, I don't know, we were, like, probably high school. And so it was just, like, pop star. But I'm sure
that would have hit more to me if it was, like, Miley Cyrus Wrecking Ball or something.
Yeah,
you know, like,
definitely. Definitely.
Cause yeah, I kind of forget that Lady Gaga was crazy. Just like Lady Gaga just seems so like influential, you know what I mean, and so big that it's like I don't.
It seems like so part of the DNA of pop culture to us.
Yeah, I don't think of her as out, you know, like as crazy, you know, or like anything like, I don't know.
Too outlandish.
Yeah, yeah.
Dude, the one moment where like they're playing the Wii and the little girl is singing High School Musical, I was like, damn, I remember that.
I liked when Sam early on was like singing Britney Spears too.
Yeah, that was funny.
Yeah.
She had hilarious energy in the beginning.
Yeah, she was really funny in the beginning. And then she just became like, that's interesting. I forgot how funny she was because she became so like, yeah. You know, not like that exactly, but she was just very like, you know. I don't know.
Chilled out.
Yeah, sassy. You know. Yeah.
But then you got to remember, like, she was also going, like, as she was hitting puberty, like, all that stuff happened with the one dude.
Yeah.
Man, that the scene where, like, she's going through their phones, and he's like, have you talked to her?
Yeah.
That was intense.
Yeah.
And then they have, like, she shows up, and she's like, get out. And they're like, what's happening?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that was crazy.
That all that was just so well done. And I notice more on rewatches, you'll notice he, like, quickly is always drinking pretty heavily. Like, at that dinner, like, he's like, let's get another bottle of wine after the honeymoon.
Yeah.
And then, like, I don't know.
Yeah, he's hiding the liquor.
I could also, like, relate to, like, adults being, like, too critical of you, if that makes sense. Being like, oh, you didn't finish the chores? Like, oh,
yeah.
You're supposed to do the chores. That's why we had you.
Yeah.
I don't know. Like, intense adults were not my friends. Well, obviously. But I have bad memories of intense adults. Yeah. Not even, like, family members. Just, like, I don't know. Teachers and some shit.
There's a fly.
Yeah, I've been noticing it.
God damn it.
A fly in the wall, there's a fly. And then I just, that last song is just, I love that song. They're like, let me go, I don't want to be your hero. As he's like driving off in the distance with the Yo Toyota.
Yeah, I thought that should have been the end.
Yeah, that's fair. I like his little talk with the girl though.
Yeah.
Where she's
it,
like.
That was cool because he's like, it seemed like he really found like someone that like, you know what I mean? Kind of like him. And
yeah.
That's even what, you know. The one teacher is like, oh, yeah, you really find your people in college. And it's like, yeah, it's like once you're out of high school, it's like none of that shit even matters anymore. It's kind of like a whole new.
You start to settle into your tribe.
Yeah, it literally is a whole new chapter. And then.
Yeah. And like she's going on about her love of like dance. And there's like that connection of like, oh, she must have gone through this whole journey of her life. Like to get to that moment where she's like so open about her love of dance and her passion. I also just love the dude who's like clearly extremely baked and he's like. All of space and time to get to this moment to stand here and scream, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
That felt like very, like,
yeah.
You're 19 and you're just getting really ripped.
Stoned. That's the one thing I wish I could experience in life is, like, the dorm life of just being, like, you know, like, 18, 19 and just going off to a college and, like, I don't know.
Yeah. One of my friend, Brooke, that's in France that I went and saw, I literally met her because she just saw into my dorm room. Like, it was, like, set up like these, and she could see into ours. So she came over just to let us know that she could see into our room, and she thought that was strange. And then we became friends after that.
Hell yeah.
But then there's also a bunch of weird people, too. I don't know.
Yeah.
Hit or miss. But I don't know. It's like you were saying, you sort of, like, settle into the people you actually want to settle into.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like when he, like, pulls off to the side and he's taking a few pictures and stuff. It's nice.
Yeah.
And he kind of always has, like, a little creative soul, which is nice, too. He's a very curious kid growing up.
Yeah. Yeah, the dead bird. That was, like, a quick little moment.
Oh, yeah. There are just, like, little tiny moments.
Yeah, but then, because I remember Ian being, like, kind of alarmed by it. And I'm like, I just remember being a kid, though, and, like, seeing, like, my first dead animal and just being like,
what the fuck?
Like, you got to kind of stare at it for a while, you know, like, what the fuck? That is a dead animal. Like, I've seen those birds flying around. Like, now that thing is half decomposing. Like,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah. I loved that. We talked about the ripstick.
Yeah.
Those scenes when they were, like, skating around. That's nice.
Yeah, I mean, early on, I'm like, I just, you know, was so excited to just see how things changed, knowing that the world just changed, you know what I mean? And they did it. Yeah, it was cool. You know, the Soldier Boy was funny. You know, and it's cool how they did, like, those little moments, you know? Yeah,
because, like, there will never be a time where it was like that to be, you know what I mean? They really capture what it felt like to be a kid in that decade.
People need to do more movies like this, really.
Yeah, because I feel like in a lot of ways it documented that time really well.
Mm-hmm.
But also, it allowed for so many different, like, story explorations and character payoffs. I think, like, you know, when I first saw, I've said it already a little bit, but, like, when I first saw it, I really paid attention to, like, Mason's growth. But, like, the movie does an incredible job of, like, all the characters growing.
Yeah.
Like, even the sister. Like, I haven't really even considered her. You know, like, she goes off and has this whole life in Austin already.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's cool. They have a nice relationship between the two of them.
Yeah, definitely.
Although when she's given the toast, she's like, I forget what she
said. Good luck. Yeah. But that's pretty. That seemed real to me, too.
That seems real. Like, of course. She's. Yeah. I mean, like, she's in her moody teen or moody 20 years.
Yeah.
In some ways. It was funny that the dishwasher guy showed up.
Yeah.
Or the owner. Yeah, but I think he showed up genuinely.
Yeah, and then it was so fucked up because he was like, yeah, he's like, and if you ever, you know, if you don't get a job, you come back, I might make you front of house. It was like, shut the fuck up. Like, that made me so, I was like, yo, shut up, dude. Like, that just reminded me of every manager I ever had. It's like, yo, if I had a manager at, like, my graduation or something, and they would have said that, that would have just been so terrible.
Yeah. And the mom's so cool. It's so cool how, like, I don't know, she really grinds. Like, on her own dreams and her kids' dreams.
Yeah, she had a lot of changes. She was, you know, a lot of different people. And
she, like, sets, in a lot of ways, like, she sets down a path at the beginning of the movie, and, like, she reaches it. And then I feel like she's, like, what's next?
But she doesn't know. But it also seems like she kind of falls off that a little bit, you know? She starts, like, selling some stuff, and, you know, they hit, like, money troubles after that, and she kind of...
Yeah.
I think she goes through shit after that, you know? I guess does she get her master's after that? Like...
Yeah, I think she had... gotten her master's when she was like working the job post master's when she had that house, but she couldn't afford it with just one salary, I think, is the gist. Mm-hmm. She cuts that guy out quick though.
Yeah.
And that was nice.
Yeah, they didn't even show that. It was just quick.
He transition. Starts to get on Mason for his fingernails. His sister stands up for him though, but she kind of also makes fun of him the same moment.
Yeah, he's just trying to be cool.
That's funny.
Yeah.
But I like that, that moment was nice.
Yeah.
Should we rate the movie?
Yeah, I think so. I know what you're giving it.
Yeah, it's a 10 for me.
It's a 10 for me.
Woo!
10's on the board.
Let's go.
10's on the board. The winner.
That's a...
You did it, Steve. You've been talking about this movie for so long, and you did it.
I know. Yeah, I would love to know the episode that like I first mentioned movie making up here.
Yeah.
It had been a... Like,
you should do that research, man. Maybe make a little...
I will.
Maybe make a little clip.
I will. I'll try to find it. It's definitely towards the end of an episode that I remember talking about it, like once or twice. Maybe when Rob was on it at some point.
I was going to say, we've talked about it with Rob. I know that.
Yeah, because I don't know. There's something nice about...
Where's the AI where you can just, like, look up, like, Boyhood, you know, like, type in, like, like you say, like, Boyhood.
It scans through all of our texts.
Yeah, scans your voice specifically and, like, finds it.
I'm sure that it exists. It would take some time to set up, though.
You know, I saw a video on YouTube. Since we rated the movie, yeah, we can.
Yeah.
We can move on, but.
I will say, I think this is added to my list of Corey Tens of Stevie picks.
Yeah, I'm basically just, like. Like you got a crown of being a good movie picker. So
that's all I need.
I'm gonna stop showing any signs of hesitation because
the one thing I was worried about this one was that it was like a 2-hour and 46-minute movie.
Yeah, it definitely derailed me at first, but yeah, it was like even it was funny because Ian was sitting down there and we're kicking for a second. I'm like, if you wanna watch this movie, you know you can. And I'm like, but it is 2-hour and 40. He's like, yeah, nah. and then we started it and. And then, like, 40 minutes passed, and Ian was still watching. And
yeah.
Yeah, and I'm like, and I was like, yeah, this is a good movie. Like, and I was like, I don't even care. I'm, like, kind of excited that it's 2 hours and 40 minutes. And, it made me excited that it was after seeing, like, how it started, you know.
I feel like it's a great pace, too. It never feels, like, too long.
Yeah.
This is my last comment that I just thought of, but the one thing that it feels weird now watching it, but it, like, didn't feel weird as a kid, was the Pledge of Allegiance in class. I don't know. It feels, like, weird to watch all these kids be like...
Pledge of Allegiance is pretty weird. It was also weird noticing that they had the little Texas the salute to the left, you know?
We love Texas.
But it made me think, I'm like, do they specifically put the Texas flag at, like, a different corner of the room? You know what I mean? And make people, like, always... Like, that's, like, some almost Hitler shit, like... You know, and then it was very quick, too. It was like, I pledge allegiance to the Texas flag.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
I think it might be a thing.
Just two lines, too, or something like.
People love Texas.
Crazy. Texas is cool, but damn.
Yeah. I love all the desert scenes.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, the one. Sorry, I just keep thinking the scene where he's like, and she doesn't even like the best movies that came out this year, like Batman,
yeah.
Superbad, and I forget the other
Pineapple
one.
Pineapple Express.
Yeah. And it's like, oh man, like that's a classic, like eighth grader.
Yeah.
Take on things.
But then I was like, is she cute? And he was like, yeah. He was like, yeah. And he's like, all right. And then he gave him the advice. He's like, you know what you need to do? He's like, you need to ask, you know, he's like, you need to let girls ask questions. Or he's like, you need to ask girls questions and then just listen.
That's good advice.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, it's shitty that it has to be like advice like that. You know what I mean? Like, it seems natural, but it also is. Like, yo, just like, that should be like advice for parenting too. Like, yo, like, ask them questions and then listen.
Yep.
You know, like, listen to them, you know?
Yeah. And I feel like they were really good parents in a lot of ways.
Yeah. I think maybe I'm like biased in certain ways. I think the mom was kind of like she was going through it, and maybe that's part of the single mother like act too, you know what I mean, of like and having to raise him, but like she had her ups and downs, you know what I mean, for sure, you know what I mean? And they do make the dad look like a saint, and I think that has to do with single mother who has to actually deal with the real bullshit.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And, like, the dad who is the
just
weekend
gets to sweep
dad.
In.
You know what I mean? Yeah.
Yeah. And can clean up his act a lot easier.
Yeah, so I think it's easy to say he's a great dad, too, but, you know, and I'm not even trying to say that she's a bad mom. I just think that they definitely show, like, you know, because that's, that, like, to me, it's, like, a tough moment, like, seeing her be, like, I don't know what the next step is. Yeah. Crying to her kids saying that, and their kids are young. You know what I mean? That's a tough fucking thing. You know what I mean? Like, that's something I've seen, too. You know what I mean? Like, and that's, like...
You mean, like, pretty... Like, when she leaves that one dude?
Yeah, the first one. Yeah, yeah, the first one. And she's like, I don't fucking know what's next. You know yeah. what I mean? Like, and it's, like, that's tough, and, like, that shouldn't be put on kids at all. You know what I mean? Like...
Yeah. I think it also like, goes to show just, like, how shitty men are, if yeah. that makes sense.
Yeah.
And how hard it can be to find, like...
Yeah.
Someone to, like, settle, you know what I'm saying, and be a good father figure.
Yeah.
She definitely does her best at all times.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. And I started off maybe sounding a little negative
to her.
No,
but I get what you're saying. It's just that, you know, like, when you're with somebody 95% of their life, like, you're going to also be there for more of the bad moments and the good, more of the good moments. You know what I'm saying? But...
Yeah.
Because you're, like, having to live yeah. with them. It also like lets Ethan Hawke's character like have more time to like get his life in order.
Yeah.
Like he has the weeks to do that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you don't even know what he does. He never says what he does really, besides like that one time when he's like, oh, I'm working for an insurance company.
Yeah, I think that's what he does.
Yeah.
But I don't know. You're right. He only says it once.
Yeah.
I liked when he was like, I thought you were a musician.
He's like, well, yeah, I mean, you got to pay the bills, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, that there were so many things in this movie.
Oh, it was a great run. I'm glad you watched it. I'm glad we finally got to do it.
Yeah, great movie.
It's one that I really like to revisit.
Yeah.
And I think there's stuff to get out of it each revisit.
Yeah, this is easily a top 20 movie.
Yeah. I feel like Richard Linklater is such a unique director. Without feeling like overly stylized.
Yeah.
Like very story focused.
Yeah, but yeah, it's almost amazing to think that it's like this is the dude that did School of Rock, you know. Yeah. And they filmed School of Rock in the middle of this.
Yep.
You know, like that's the other funny thing. Like this movie started before School of Rock came out.
And then he got bigger, you know?
Yeah.
Crazy. What was that video you were gonna say you watched? I cut you off.
Oh. Because we were talking about AI, right?
Yeah, yeah.
It's dumb. But I saw a video, and it said Donald Trump, Joe Biden, and Barack Obama.
Are they playing, like, Call of Duty or, like, Valorant or something like that?
No, they're picking their Zelda tier list. And it was, like, it's so funny because they're, like, they're just, like, debating on, like, minish cap. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And, like, you know, distinctive ways of how to get hearts in that game. You know what I mean?
It's like, so specific.
And it's like, oh, fuck you, Biden. And Trump's, like, you know, being very business-minded about it all. But, like, I'm like, wow, like, whoever wrote these scripts or whatever, like, this is crazy. Like,
I mean, I think...
Because it sounds like what they would say, like, about certain shit, like, it, their personalities. Like,
yeah. My one of my favorites of that whole batch thing is, like, the Joe Rogan and Ben Shapiro Ratatouille thing.
What? It's and the three of them?
It's just Ben Shapiro and Joe Rogan, and Joe's like... You're telling me you wouldn't love, like, a little rat on the top of your head that's helping you cook? And he's like, no, Joe, what I'm telling you is that the whole idea is preposterous. Like, why would you want a rat to cook? And they're like, and Joe's just, like, really, like, it, like, you know, being, like, kind of a stoner about it and being like, isn't it sound, like, so crazy, though? You're telling me you wouldn't want this? I don't know. Those videos are so silly. Yeah. And kind of freaky.
Yeah, they're weird.
AI, man, taking over in weird ways. I don't know how I feel about it.
Yeah. I don't know how I feel about Nintendo.
The Direct? The Pokemon?
Yeah. Stupid.
I think it's coming. I think it's coming.
Stupid.
I think they're just like, they wanted to announce the Game Boy games being there, and then they'll announce it again later on.
They put out a new Switch Online video yesterday.
Really?
And it reiterates that Stadium will not have transferability.
Yet.
It doesn't say yet.
I know. It's I don't even know what meme it is, but it's just me constantly getting my hopes up, ready to be crushed over
and
over again.
Yeah, like,
I think it's crazy because I would pay $5 just to have, I would pay, you know, like, that's what it is.
Everybody would.
Yeah, everyone would.
Everybody's fine with that.
Yeah, and what's crazy is, like, if you go on Twitch, or not Twitch, but yeah, probably even Twitch, or like TikTok Live, there's so many people playing ROM Pokemon games. And it's like, you're missing out on all of this money.
Yeah. They broke down the percentage of, like, the sales of, like, the OG ones versus, like, also, like, the percentage of Switch Online subscribers and, like, how much money they make from that and, like, they're virtually making, like, more money if they put it on Switch Online right now. You know what I mean? Like, its percentage value compared to every other game on Switch Online and how much money they're making is, like, gonna make them, like, $17 million.
Crazy.
And, like, it made $10 million. Like, they sold $10 million.
Crazy.
Like, on 3DS originally.
Crazy.
To where it's, like...
Why not just do it and make the money?
Yeah. Or fucking sell it, you know, like, whatever, you know, like...
Just give
or
us
make
access
a,
to it.
You know, or make a $5 Pokemon app.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
I mean, it's like what we were saying earlier about the movies and stuff like that. Like, when you make it difficult for people to obtain something, even, like, legitimately, like, you're just going to...
That's been their problem forever,
you're just
going
to route people, like, doing ROMs and hacks and...
Yeah. That's what they've been doing to people forever, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it really made sense, like, if the 3DS shit is closing this month.
To launch it something new?
Yeah. You know, a month early, you know? It would have made so much sense. Like, it made so much sense. And that's why it's like, all right, like, this is hurtful, you know? It's like...
Yeah.
And to not do anything, DLC is, like, pretty, like that's pretty late coming.
It's the end of the year, right?
Yeah, well, it's summer, yeah. It's fall and winter.
Yeah.
Like, that's pretty late coming.
It's pretty late. I'll give you that.
You know, and
I
the,
feel like
and
they're also just trying not to... They know people are going to be playing Tears. But also, maybe that means the system's coming.
True, but they could have done, like, a July. You know, that's 2 months after Tears.
That's true.
You know.
Maybe they're also like, we can't fuck this one up. Like, that we gotta get the glitches
out. And that's
what
some people are saying, too. But, you know, but also, I'm pretty sure the data's in the game already. Like, I think that's how a lot of downloadable content, like, has worked. Like, that's how it worked for Sword and Shield, too. It was, like, in the game. And, like, the downloadable content was, like, 8 megabytes of, like, little patches and updates. And
I, like, was also really hoping for a mystery dungeon game.
Yeah.
Did you ever play those?
No.
They're pretty fun.
Yeah. I mean, they could have done. I wasn't expecting, you know.
They're fun because, like, you're instead of walking around as a trainer, you're walking around as the Pokemon. Hmm. And, like, you get your little trio team.
You battle?
You, like, have to get to the end of the dungeon. Yeah, you battle. Like, Pokemon that are in your way.
Mm.
It's fun. And then you, like, run into legendaries sometimes, too.
Okay. Yeah, that would be cool. They should have something coming. You know?
Hopefully. Hopefully. Dude, I finally beat my first non-Pokemon game. Like, in years.
You beat Outer Wilds?
Outer Wilds, yeah.
Hell yeah.
Incredible game.
Hell yeah.
It's, I think if you have the PlayStation Online, it's free right now.
Okay.
But, I don't know. I have never really played a game that, like, you know, like, there's, it's a completely open world. You're just trying to, like, piece together the puzzle, kind of.
Yeah.
And it's, like, on a loop. So, like.
Yeah.
And, like, certain things happen in the world at certain times. So, like, I don't know. It was just really fun. And then, like, the ending was incredible.
Yeah, I'd have to play it for myself because I think I've seen a little bit about it, like, you know, a YouTube video of people playing it, you know, and it seems interesting. Like, those games that, like, yeah, like, I do like the, like, survival games where it's like you die. If you die, you die, you know, and you just start over. I think those are interesting concepts, but I think that's, like, a whole different spin on it. It's, yeah, like, almost like a narrative-based game with that.
I'm guessing. It's cool, too, because, like, it's like what you're saying, like, you get somewhere all... Sometimes, like, you get so far, and then, like, you accidentally run out of air or, like, gas, and, like, you have to start the whole loop over and do all the steps to get back to that place because you still have more information you need to get there.
Yeah.
And it's cool. Like, there's a big lore, and it was spooky and fun like that.
Oh, yeah.
It definitely got me back into gaming, but also had me, like... I was like, man, video games are, like, so addictive to me.
Yeah.
Like, just me personally. I played it until I beat it, like, 6 hours a night and just, like, grinded it.
Yeah. I'm pretty bad, too. I'll play a game for, you know, a week straight, you know, especially shorter games that it's like...
I'm just like, I'm so close to being done.
Yeah.
Like, let's just do it.
Yeah. Gotta grind it out.
But I know when I start, like, Last of Us or something like that, I'm gonna do the same thing.
Last of Us is a steady 15-hour game.
That's cool.
Last of Us Part 2 is 30.
Oh, my gosh. Is it gonna be 2 seasons? You think so? Like, 2 seasons for Part 2?
That'd be a one to break it up in.
Yeah, I'd be interested to see how they're gonna do it. I mean, I don't know a lot that happens in 2 besides the first part.
Well, everything is right.
Yeah, it was our pizza.
I wish. I'm hungry as fuck. I gotta go cook a pizza.
Me too.
I'm starving.
Me too.
It's a little late. We might as well just wrap up the pod. I looked at my topics on my phone while we was breaking, and I ain't got none.
This whole time, you had actually just texted Ian to go around front, ring the doorbell, so you could take a break.
Wrap up the pod.
So you could look at your topics to make sure that there's nothing left for us to talk about.
No.
I feel like it's been a pretty slow week.
Yeah, like, news-wise. I feel like yeah. You said movie-wise?
News-wise.
Oh, news-wise. Yeah, I mean, I don't know.
You know my favorite, like, litmus test to ask people our age to see if they're, like, hip on the internet or, like, out of touch now? Not out of touch, but, like, disconnected.
What?
I'll be like, do you know who Ice Spice is? And the people that are, like, on the internet are like, yeah, I know who Ice Spice is.
Yeah.
And then the older people that, they're like, who's Ice Spice? It's hilarious. Some people don't know who Ice Spice is.
That's crazy.
She's got more monthly listeners than the Beatles.
Really?
Like, right now. But, yeah.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Damn.
Just by a little bit.
That's fucked up.
Well, yeah. But, I mean,
that's
still
fucked up.
Still 28 million for the Beatles.
That's fucked up.
She's having a moment.
She got more slaps than the Beatles?
Just more monthly listeners at the moment.
She got more fans than the Beatles?
Grabbing my Federer.
Jesus Christ. No, because there's a lot more people listening to the Beatles, like, on the radio and in CDs. And
yeah, I mean, it's hard to imagine in 40 years even Drake will have as many streams as the Beatles are getting right now. Maybe that's wrong, though.
Yeah, that's wrong.
Sorry, Drake. I didn't mean it.
That's wrong.
Did you watch that Yachty Drake interview?
Nope, but I want to.
There's just like a clip where Yachty's like, Drake, you're getting up there. And he's like, no, I'm not. And he's like, you kind of are.
I'm going to watch that tonight.
He's like, I guess you're right. He's like, Drake, when I'm your age, you're going to be having a cane. But like, he's joking at that point. But there's a moment where it's like setting in on Drake. And he's like, oh, my God. It's like, I am like 36.
Drake is like, I need more funny Drake interviews.
Yeah.
That one is just so good, you know, him and his son.
If you could bet on anything, what would you bet on? Fatherhood.
Oh my God.
It's just so funny because Drake, like, you know, like in his lyrics, they're often like very witty and like very well thought together. But then sometimes in like interview form, like he's so goofy and like I feel like the pressure of like in the momentness mixed with people who are like interviewing him for like LOLs. It's just priceless.
Yeah. Yeah. I need the chicken shop date.
Oh my God.
That needs to happen. She's got a cooking show that's pretty funny.
I've seen an episode or two of that.
Yeah.
It's funny when she'll be at like the concerts of some of the people that she like interviews on.
Yeah.
And I think that's fun.
Yeah.
Well,
yep.
It's been a good pod. Glad we're back in it.
Yep. We're back.
I forgive you for teleporting us out of nowhere today.
Yep. We might be teleported into a different room next time. Who knows? We're getting close. We'll be fully set up by episode 100. We will be set up in our new digs.
It's coming closer every day.
We will be back in action fully. We will be peak Corey and Stevie Movie Club.
Movie Club, 100 plus is gonna be our prime time.
Yeah.
Prime time club.
Takes 100 episodes to figure it out.
100 episodes to figure it out.
That you know, they said we put so many hours in it. We may have done. We got 10,000 hours of pod?
No, not yet. Definitely not yet. When we get to 1,000, maybe we will be. Not even.
That's what I'm saying.
Oh my gosh. We're up there though. Yeah. We're getting better at it.
We got a good 4,000-5,000 hours of pod.
It feels like it for sure.
I'm pretty sure they told us we did like 5,000 hours like last year.
5,000 minutes.
Oh.
We're definitely at 10,000 minutes though. So put that as you like, Malcolm Gladwell. Do you know what our pick is next week?
No.
You don't have to answer it now. There's no need for pressure.
Say something. Let me...
Say a movie?
No, I guess let me just speak.
Well, while Corey's thinking, I'd like to say thanks to all the listeners for listening. I especially thank you if you would follow us at movieclub.com, which hopefully is a website at some point. Maybe movieclub.blog. Maybe movie.club. Maybe movie.club.com.co.
Fantasia.
Damn. All right, let's get it.
That's on Disney Plus, right? Probably?
Probably.
Has to be.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, we doing Fantasia. Hopefully that's not, like, subtly weird in any ways. Can't be, right?
No, I don't think so.
Sick.
I think it's like one of their classics.
Yeah.
I would love to talk about a Creed movie next week, if you've seen it.
Yeah.
Three.
I'm trying to see Creed. We should see three. I'm trying to see Creed.
Yeah. Bump, 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 bump. It's like, that's a Rocky song.
Eye of the Tiger?
No, it's like trumpets. You got it. Yes.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I know the Rocky song.
Yeah. Yeah, they play it strategically. Tessa Thompson's in the Creed movies.
Yeah. I heard she's got a significant role in this, too. It's not like...
Yeah, yeah. I think her character's based off FKA Twigs a little bit, too.
Weird.
But cool.
Weird. All right, let's see Creed this weekend. Let's go...
Let's go movies.
Let's go fucking Saturday or Sunday. I don't care.
I'm down.
Bet. Let's do it. Let's do a now showing.
I'll be down.
You want to?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
It's been a minute.
All right. Sounds good. Nice seeing you, Stevie.
Nice seeing you, Corey. Nice seeing you, listeners.
Yeah. We're back, YouTube. Sorry for the break. Sorry, everybody. We're back.
Back in action.
Fucking break, buddy.
Oh, shit.